do the right thing, 'cause it's the right thing to do, even when you know nobody's wrong.
Good morning, boys and girls, and welcome to Gateway Kids Elementary. I am so glad you're joining me this morning. We are getting very, very, very close to being able to go back to being in person. And I am so excited. I can't wait to see your faces in person. We're going to continue our study and finish it up this week on the virtue of integrity. Integrity is choosing to be truthful in whatever you say or do. And we've seen over the last 3 weeks, throughout different Bible stories, how God has shown us that we can be truthful in what we say and do. And this week it's a story. Actually, it's not a story. It's about a scripture, a specific scripture. And the scripture is from Philippians 4, verses 8 and 9. And it's the Apostle Paul who is talking. And he's going to give us some great, great instructions for learning how to be truthful. And the title of the story is called Always on My Mind. And today, Miss Terry's going to be teaching it, but our bottom line is focus on what is true. That's a really good piece of advice. We could focus on many things that are going on around us, and some may be true and some may be not, but we know this. We have always said in elementary that the Bible is what? The Bible is true, that it is God's word and it is true. And that is where we're going to focus at. And in talking about it, integrity, when it's choosing to be truthful in whatever you say or do, it boils down to one of our core values, you know, the ones that Miss Terry has said that are on the wall down in Kidstown 1 and 3. And it's the one that says, I can make a wise choice. So it's a choice to be truthful. I want to say this morning to my birthday friends, stand up. I want you to feel the love this morning Miss Terry has for you and tell you happy birthday. Here's your air hug. I wish I could do that in person. Soon, maybe soon we can, but I want to tell you to have a wonderful, wonderful birthday today with your friends and your family, however you're celebrating. And I send you the best wishes ever for a great birthday. Boys and girls, I have enjoyed being able to come to you this way, virtually, but I look forward to seeing you in person. So now let's just bow our heads and pray and thank God, and then we will bring out His crew and get started. Heavenly Father, we are so grateful for this day. We are so grateful for you, Father, and the way that you love us, the way that you watch over us and protect us, God. We thank you for that, God. With a grateful heart, Father, we come before you, and we ask that, Lord, you would help to, your Spirit would lead and guide us to be truthful in all of our ways, in what we say and in what we do, because we know that is how we gain trust. Lord, thank you for allowing us over these last 8 months to be able to come to you, to the children this way through a television set. Many, many years ago, this would not have been possible. So we thank you for the ability to do that, God. But we look forward to being back in person, face to face, sharing the gospel with these children. Lord, open our hearts and our minds today to the truth of your word. And all God's children said, amen. All right, boys and girls, it's time to stand up. It's time to call out His crew. Everybody stand up. On the count of three, here we go. One, two, three.
So simple, faith like a child. I give you an inch and you take me a mile. I feel the wind rush and the thunder roll. I
the devil tries to shake me, I just pray harder. Even in my darkest hour, got Holy Ghost power. When I keep my eyes upon you, Jesus, I'm a wave walker. I'm a wave walker. I'm dancing on water. When the devil tries to shake me, I just pray harder. Even in my darkest hour, got Holy Ghost power. When I keep my eyes upon you, Jesus, I'm a wave walker.
We'll be right back.
Kidstown. It's one of our favorite ones that his crew does. But have you ever thought about Don't Ever Stop? What does that song mean? He says, whatever is true, whatever is right, whatever is pure, whatever is light. Lead me in your way everlasting. Don't ever stop. Don't ever stop. It's a great song. I love that song. It's one of my very favorites. But today we're going to talk about our story today. It's called Always on My Mind. And it's going to come from the Apostle Paul. It's not going to be a story where people are in it and things are happening. It's from a scripture. And this scripture particularly tells us how we can have integrity, what we've been studying all month. And that's choosing to be truthful in whatever you say or do. And today's bottom line is focus on what is true. So we're going to watch the story, and then we're going to come back, and Miss Terry's going to talk a little bit about it. Enjoy the story.
This isn't going to work. I'm going to do really bad today. I'm going to forget what I have to say. I might as well just give up.
Hi, I'm Graham, and I'm going to fail. Sorry, but I'm just trying to be honest. I'm trying to have integrity. Integrity is choosing to be truthful in whatever you say and do. And the truth is, the speech I have to give later today is going to go badly. I am supposed to talk to a bunch of strangers about different kinds of masks, but every time I give a speech, I get so nervous that everything I want to say comes out wrong. I don't know if this happens to you, but I keep hearing these voices in my head.
You're not very good at talking to people.
When you tell jokes, they stink.
Other people are way better at this than you.
The more I listen to these voices, the more I believe them. So it's probably better if I don't even do the speech today. Can't mess up if I don't try, right?
That way you won't be embarrassed.
Good point, Teddy Bear Voice. So in today's story, we're learning about how to control what you think. Like that would be helpful. Wait, would that be helpful?
No. I mean, nay.
Aw, thanks for being honest, weird horse voice. I knew I could count on you.
The Bible. It's 66 books of history, stories, letters, and poetry that fit together to form God's one big story. The epic adventure of how he created us and loves us so much that he made a way to rescue us. As we travel through the Bible, from Genesis to Revelation, we discover people who met God and found their lives changed forever. Now, for an amazing story. Inspired by the book of Philippians, chapter 4, verse 8.
Horatio liked to keep track of things in his head. Five kinds of cereal in the cabinet. 17 braids on his sister Nala's head. 2 voicemail messages left on his parents' landline phone.
Seriously, Mom? You are so stuck in the 1990s.
Horatio was especially good at keeping track of things that went wrong.
Number 1, we're out of chocolate frosted sugar bomb cereal.
Horatio's mother did not always appreciate his lists.
I did not buy that. Your dad bought that.
Number 2, it is freezing in here.
Put on a sweater.
Number 3, Miss Watson is making us do a group project, and they are the worst because everyone else drags me down.
Horatio, can you please focus on something positive for once?
Just keeping it real.
Oh, I know about positive stuff. Miss Christie told us.
Horatio's little sister, Nala, began rummaging around in the stacks of random paper on the counter.
There is nothing positive about this morning, and I'm positive about that.
Nala pulled out a scribbled-on handout and waved it triumphantly.
Philippians 4:8.
Do not read me a coloring sheet.
Finally, my brothers and sisters, always think about what is true. Think about what is noble, right, and pure.
Mom, make her stop bugging me.
No, this is good.
Think about what is lovely and worthy of respect. If anything is excellent or worthy of praise, think about those kinds of things.
Horatio just glared and checked out the lunch that Mom had packed.
Is this strawberry jam in my sandwich? You know I only eat apricot jam.
Over the next 2 hours, Horatio counted dozens of annoying things.
Number 1, this bus stinks like dirty socks stuffed with Cheetos. Number 2, the classroom door needs some WD-40. Number 3, Miss Watson is wearing yellow, and I hate yellow. Number 4, this pencil is making a giant callus on my finger. Number 5, group projects are still the worst. Number 6, it's way too hot over here.
And to make matters worse, Miss Watson had put Tish James in charge of the group. Ugh.
So, we get to do a report on Cape Hatteras Lighthouse. I'll write the history, and Jordan, you can paint a picture, and Horatio, you research stuff about the land and animals around it.
Number 7. Tish is super bossy.
Oh, and here's a picture of the lighthouse.
Tish held up a glossy photograph and Horatio opened his mouth, ready to complain about how boring lighthouses were. But he couldn't do it. Hatteras Lighthouse, spiraling into the sunset sky, was breathtaking. He could picture walking the beach and waves crashing as the warm light glowed overhead. Ah. And Horatio couldn't help hearing an echo of his little sister's voice.
Think about what is lovely and worthy of respect.
There it was, right in front of his face. Horatio found brand new thoughts forming in his brain.
Hey, that looks really cool. That's amazing.
It was as if a switch had flipped in Horatio's head. After seeing one good thing, he started to see more. Jordan had brought in some paintings he had done.
Number one, Jordan, you are a really great artist.
Miss Watson helped Horatio solve some tough fractions by drawing a funny sketch.
Number two, Miss Watson is a super creative teacher.
Mom had packed homemade cookies in Horatio's lunch.
Number three, my mom makes the best chocolate chip cookies on the planet. Who wants to share?
By the time Horatio got off the school bus,
number four, Mr. Rob drove us right up to our house because of the rain.
He was actually smiling. Mom met them at the door.
Hey kids, how was school?
At that moment, Nala shook out her wet umbrella all over Horatio. And for a moment, Horatio frowned. Nala braced herself.
Sorry.
Number five, I have a closet full of dry clothes upstairs.
Nala's eyebrows shot way up.
What happened to you?
Nothing. I just realized I've got some pretty great things to focus on.
So your day went okay?
Number six. It was positively awesome.
Horatio beamed and ran upstairs to change his wet shirt. He had a lot of brand new lists to make up in his head.
The Apostle Paul wrote, "Finally, my brothers and sisters, always think about what is true. Think about what is noble, right, and pure. Think about what is lovely and worthy of respect. If anything is excellent or worthy of praise, think about those kinds of things." You know what that means? It means you're in charge of what you think about. Maybe you can't control every single thought that enters your brain.
Think about fish. You must think about...
But you can control the thoughts that you focus on. Yes, you can. Having integrity doesn't just mean you're honest with other people. It means you're honest with yourself too. And to do that, you need to try and focus on things that you know are true. Things like,
God made you.
God forgives you. God loves you.
He loves you so much that he sent Jesus to die on a cross for you. And he's big enough to bring Jesus back from the dead. So he's bigger than all of the things that you and I worry about. So the one thing to remember from today is this. Focus on what's true. And if you ever feel like you can't control your thoughts, or if the voices inside seem too loud, talk to someone you trust about it. Find someone who will help you stay focused on the truth of God's amazing love for you. You know what? I'm gonna choose not to believe the voices that are telling me that I'm not any good. God made me. I am good. And then I'm going to try to give the best speech that I can. Bet you didn't see that coming, did you?
No! I mean, nope.
Yeah, I thought not. I'll see you around, everybody. I'll be thinking about you. Bye.
All right, boys and girls, that was a cute story with all the different head pieces and pandas and horses and fish and all that. But putting all that aside, that was a silly way to portray it, but it was a fun way to think about. I love the way that the guy said that, that you are in charge of your thoughts. You are in charge of your thoughts. And you may feel like you can't always control them. Sometimes they venture off to some other way of thinking. But he gives us a good outline for being able to keep our thoughts. There's one scripture that I love that says, take every thought captive. Think about that. So if you start to think something that you know that's not in line with God's word, take it captive. Take it captive. And one way to do that is to keep God's truth of his word at the forefront of our minds. That scripture says, finally, brothers and sisters, always think about what's true. Think about what is noble, what is right, what is pure. Think about what is lovely and worthy of respect. If anything is excellent or worthy of praise, think about those kinds of things. Do what you have learned or received or heard from me and follow my example, he said. I love that scripture. And it's just, it's talking about, he's challenging us. The Apostle Paul is saying to think how we currently think and then move forward into godly thinking. And the way that we do that is to think on truth. We know that God's word is true. We know that every scripture is God-breathed. And so when we spend time in God's word, reading his truth and filling our minds with that, it leaves a lot less room for the things that don't line up with his word. Instead of focusing on things that really don't matter and getting all worked up over that and allowing it to steal your joy, try this. Focus on God's amazing love for you. God made you. He loves you. And he wants what's best for you. Integrity not only means being truthful in whatever you say and do to others. Integrity means being truthful with yourself. Ask God to examine your heart today and show you the things that are not of him that are in your life. Eliminate those things and the joy abounds. And so I like to think of, how we think ultimately determines how we're going to act. If we're thinking negative things and we're seeing a lot of things that aren't true and it just becomes yuck in our minds, sometimes that's how it's played out in our lives. Like Horatio in the story today, you know, he started out every day negatively, counting all the negative things in his life instead of looking at the positive things. If the only thing that was positive in our lives was that God loved us so much that he sent his son to die on the cross for our sins and then raised him up on the third day, it would be enough. And so we need to think, as Christians, that is what we believe. And so our everyday needs to reflect that. And it's hard in a world where TV and video games and many, and even people in our own lives play out right in front of us with a lot of negativity and a lot of untruth. And in order to be able to know what is untrue, we have to know what's true. And since the only thing that we know to be absolute truth is God's word, that's where we have to start. Feeding ourselves day after day with God's word, his truth. And then we will recognize the untruths. When we read God's word and we know what he has intended for us, then when we pick up a video game and something's going on in it that maybe is not in line with his word, that'll give us the strength to say, I'm not going to play that because God would not want me playing that. Or I will not watch that on TV because God would not want me to watch that and fill my mind with that. And that's not saying that you have to spend all day, every day, reading God's word, because we know that you go to school and you don't have time to do that. But when you do have time, if you use your time wisely and fill it with the truth of God's word, then you will know beyond a shadow of a doubt when lies are coming at you. What is lies and what are truth? You see, as a Christian, we have God's Spirit dwelling inside of us, living inside of us. And that gives us the ability to know the difference between right and wrong, the difference between lie and truth. And so we have the ability to do that. I want you to take that and read that scripture a few times this week. Read that over and over. Whatever's lovely, whatever's true, whatever's noble, whatever worthy of praise and respect. And examine your life this week to see which things are going on in your life that may not be fitting that list. And then try to eliminate those. I'm going to do it too. I'm not just asking you to do it. I'm going to do it as well. And so, boys and girls, I want to say that I love you guys, and I want what's best for you. But even more than me, God wants what's best for you. So let's bow our heads, and let's pray. And then, guys, I hope to see you really, really soon. God, we thank you for the truth of your word and all that it brings to us. God, in times of confusion and chaos, we know that you are not a God of chaos and confusion, but you are a God of order. You are a God of love. And Lord, that you want what's best for each one of us. I pray this week that we would all have time to sit at your feet, to read your word, so that we too might be able to gauge our daily activities against the scripture today about whatever is good, whatever is pure, whatever is light. And those things that are not of you, that we would eliminate out of our daily habits, God. We thank you that you give us the ability to see these things for what they are, and you give us the strength to move away from them, and you forgive us, God. So we thank you for all of that. We love you, Lord, and it's in your name we pray. Amen. Well, boys and girls, I will see you next week. I love you. Have a great week. All right, boys and girls, it's time for our devotion from How Great is Our God. And today's devotion that Miss Terry picked is called Say It Isn't So. The scripture is, Lord God, you are God, and your words are true. That's from 2 Samuel 7:28. Elephants drink water through their trunks like a straw. Bats are as blind as a, well, bat. An ostrich hides by sticking its head in the sand. Touching a toad will give you warts. Bulls will charge at the color red. How many of these facts have you heard? As it turns out, they aren't true. Here are the real facts. Elephants suck water only part of the way up their trunk and then pour it into their mouths. Bats mostly use sound to navigate, but they can also see. Ostriches don't stick their heads in the sand, though they might flop on the ground and play dead. No, you won't get warts by touching a toad, and bulls will charge at the color red, along with blue, green, yellow, and any color at all if it's moving. We hear some things so often that we start to think they must be true. But the thing is, this world, and the devil who roams around in it, likes to lie. It says things over and over again like, you aren't important, no one really cares about you, you're not good enough, or you've got to face your troubles all by yourself. Don't believe it. Arm yourself with God's truths by reading the Bible every day. You'll learn how special you are, how much you're loved, and how you're never alone. Then you won't be tempted to believe the lies. The prayer at the end says, Lord, I hear so many different things about who I am and who you are. Help me remember to always check your word for the truth. I know you'll never lie to me. I love that. There's a little side note over here, and it says, check out some of God's most powerful truths for yourself. God made you and knows everything about you. In Psalm 139, verses 13 and 14. God loves you so much. In John chapter 3:16 and 1 John 3:1. God never leaves you to face your troubles or celebrate your joys alone. Read Matthew 28:20 and Joshua 1:5. All right, boys and girls, it's time to do our memory verse for the last time this month. I hope you will keep learning it, and I hope you will keep practicing it, because when we do come together face to face, Miss Terry would love to hear you come up and show me the memory verse. It would make my day. So let's do it. Here we go. Remember our fist here. Anyone who lives without blame walks safely. But anyone who takes a crooked path will get caught. And that is Proverbs 10:9. Nerve! Good job. All right, let's do it one more time. I want to hear you all the way at my house, loud, proud. Here we go. Anyone who lives without blame walks safely. But anyone that takes a crooked path will get caught. Proverbs 10:9, nerve. Good job. I am so proud of you guys for sticking to it and tuning in each week. I can't wait to see you guys. I love you. Have a wonderful week.